I'm starting to think that I am sort of getting into the religion business a little bit. Now, I'm a kind of an evangelical atheist, actually. But what I recognize, there's something I recognize about religion that us evangelical atheists haven't really grappled with yet, which is that it gives people a chance to surrender. What religion says to you, essentially, is you're not in control. Now, that's a very liberating idea. It's quite a frightening idea as well in some ways, but everything else in a consumer society is essentially trying to say to you, you're in control. You can design your life just as you want it to be. You can have everything you want, and this is how you do it. You know, so the rest of life is all about control and about telling you to take control, essentially, with your wallet mostly. But basically the conceit is that freedom is control, is the ability to take control. Whereas, of course, in gospel music, which is probably the music that I listen to more than anything else, another funny thing for an evangelical atheist, but the message of gospel music is not take control, it's surrender. Everything's going to be all right, is the basic message of gospel music. And I think surrendering, of course, is something that humans used to have to do all the time. They couldn't control anything. They were at the mercy of the elements, of the other animals, at the mercy of everything, at the mercy of their health, which they couldn't do much about. So we've got into the mode of thinking that says we can control everything, but we manifestly can't. We can control a lot more than we used to be able to. But we really ought to be also prepared for this state of mind that says, I'm not in control and I like it.